In this problem, we've been tasked with modifying code we built in lecture that simulates deterministic finite state machines to also simulate non-deterministic finite state machines. So as a quick review, what makes a non-deterministic finite state machine different than a deterministic one? One thing is that a non-deterministic state machine may have epsilon transitions, which means transitions that don't require any characters in the string and are taken automatically. The other difference is that a non-deterministic machine may have two output edges that correspond to the same letter. And this causes diverging state. Simulating a string on a machine, the machine can be in multiple states at the same time. And so that's really the key, what we're going to have to modify for this problem, since we were told explicitly we do not have to worry about the epsilon transitions. The first thing we may want to go over is the notation in Python code for our machine. In the example, you were given a dictionary edges. So the keys in our dictionary indicates the state in our state machine, and the values are the other states to whom the key has an outgoing edge labeled with the second value in the tuple of the key. That may sound a bit confusing, so let's work through and draw a diagram for what this Python description represents. Let's say we always begin at state 1, which will hold true for the remainder of our examples. So here we've been given at state 1. We then have two outgoing edges to states 2 and 3, and those are labeled with the letter A. From state 2, we have one outgoing edge to state 2, labeled with the letter A. From state 3, we have two outgoing edges to 3 and 4, labeled with the letter B. And from 4, we have one outgoing edge to state 5, labeled with the letter C. And lastly, we have our accepting states, 2 and 5. So we'll use the notation of a double circle to indicate that it's an accepting state. And this is the finite state machine that this description represents. So if you're a little rusty on your non-deterministic finite automata, let's go through an example string and see whether or not it's accepted. So let's say we have the string A, A, A. We start at state 1. From 1, we take the letter A to both 2 and 3. We're in two places at the same time. At 2, we take the letter A back to 2. At 3, there are no transitions for the letter A. So in this version of our simulation, this alternative dimension, however you want to think about it, the finite state machine has failed to accept the string. However, we still have the other version of the simulation. We take the last A back the 2, and from here, we've succeeded. And by our definition of the non-determinism, if any path through the state machine results in an accepting state, then we say this machine accepts that string. Okay, let's do this once more. Here we have the string A, B, B, C. From A, we go to two states, 2 and 3. Then we have the letter B. From state 2, there's nothing we can do. From state 3, we have two outgoing edges with B. So we're now at 3 and 4. Oh, and I forgot to include this last state transition, C, which will come up in a bit. From 3, we take another B to both 3 and 4. And from 4, there's nowhere to take this B to, so we failed. And lastly, we have a C. From state 3, there's nowhere to take this C. But from 4, we can take the C to 5, which is an accepting state. So now you hopefully feel pretty good with stepping through a non-deterministic finite state machine. Now we have to actually answer the question, and that is to simulate it. And what we're going to do is pretty much what we did by hand. We're going to do it recursively. We're going to start from the starting state, and we're going to take the first character in our string and recurse on the state that that edge leads to. So at 1, we're going to take the A and recurse onto 2 with the rest of the string, and on the 3 for the rest of the string. And if any of those recursions, those recursive calls, comes back true, then we say, beginning at state 1, we return true. And it's going to go all the way back up. Let's try writing that. So here we have a procedure, the non-deterministic finite state machine simulator. I know that's a mouthful. And we take in four parameters: the string on which we're simulating, the current state, the map of edges that represents the state machine, and lastly, a list of the accepting states. So I mentioned before We're going to do this via recursion. And one of the first things you may want to think about when writing a recursive procedure is your base case. So our base case is going to happen when we have no more characters left in our string. So we have no more characters, we're simply going to return whether or not we are currently in an accepting state. And thanks to the nice Python syntax, that translates almost exactly to the code. Otherwise, we're going to look at the first character in our string. If the current state has an outgoing edge with the letter that's the first character in the string, we're going to do a recursive call for each edge. So here, I've written the code that gets out the new state, and the last thing we need to decide is what to do with what the recursive call returns. And as I said earlier, we're going to return true if any of the recursive calls that we make return true. If we go through all this mess, or if there wasn't an edge for the current letter at our present state, we're going to return false. And that's the code.